one of the fortunate few to work as an astronaut in NASA. Seeing her achievements, you can tell that she had even... this is a photo of 2006 mission in which she was the head of the mission. So seeing this, you can understand that she was having a lot of achievements. Obviously a high IQ. Now looking at the title, you might think that why the title is Lucy in the Sky and not Lisa in the Sky? Because the name is Lisa. So about that, there is a movie coming this October, which is loosely based on the life of Lisa Nowak. And let's discover why her life was so different that it is being made into a movie. So this is the list of her achievements. This is the file photo from 1996. And the last mission she went on was in 2006. But in 2007, something happened. And in Florida, she was arrested for attempted kidnapping. Now, what just went wrong? She obviously had a very good career. So as you can see, in this file photo, towards the left is her lover, who was found cheating with her, with a new woman, who was also an astronaut. And Lisa couldn't exactly take it well. So after discovering their affair, she traveled for 15 hours straight for over 900 miles wearing an astronaut government issued diaper to avoid making stops in order to confront this girl. Lisa was carrying so many arms and ammunition, including a hunting knife, gun with ammunition, a steel hammer, garbage bag, gloves, pepper spray and whatnot to confront this girl. She was but thankfully the only thing she could use on the victim was a pepper spray and she was caught. This was year 2007 and Lisa was the first astronaut who got arrested, which is not an achievement, obviously. So seeing this, what can we say? We understand that Lisa had a high IQ, but a very low EQ. Now moving on, let's see some signs of low emotional intelligence. So these are some of the signs, like being argumentative, not listening to others, blaming others, or having an emotional outburst, which was Lisa's case. Now, coming back, what is emotional intelligence? So basically in 90s, researchers came up with this concept of emotional intelligence in order to explain why intelligent people like Lisa sometimes do really stupid stuff. So the argument went like the way general intelligence or IQ is your ability to process information and come to sound decisions. Emotional intelligence or EQ is your ability to process your emotion as well as others' emotion and come to sound decisions. So let's come to the five components of the emotional intelligence. These five components constitute emotional intelligence, and these are the skills we need to work on to improve on our emotional intelligence. The first three, self-awareness, self-regulation and motivation, are the personal skills, and it depends on how we manage ourselves. The next two, empathy and social skills, are the social skills. Okay. It's the social skills with which we manage our relationship with the society. Since the time is low, I'll just tell you what it is in a very brief 1 minute. I'll just take 1 minute. So, self-awareness, as we know, is to identify our emotions. Self-regulation is to be able to control our emotions or impulses. So a major part of EQ is to feel a feeling and not act on it. For example, if you know that you hate a person, it doesn't mean that you go and stab that guy to death. That's not a solution. Or if you love someone, it doesn't allow you to follow that person all the time and become a stalker. So these two are the basic elements with which we can manage ourselves. The third one is motivation. And a motivated person is always persistent and enthusiastic. And they don't think about why this, why now, and why me. They're always self-motivated and they will work towards attaining their goal. So these three are our personal parts of emotional intelligence. Other two are empathy, the way you connect with others, and the way you can relate to their viewpoints and needs. Social skills are something which helps us to build relationships, as well as so people having social skills are excellent communicators and are good at solving disputes. So why am I talking about all this? Why do we need to work on these skills? The simple reason, and I told you a story beforehand just to underscore the value, that how bad it can go if you don't build upon your EQ. But since we are engineers, let's see some figures to understand and convince ourselves why should we increase our EQ. Okay. So as per a research conducted by Dr. Travis, he found out that top 90% of the performers of any institute were having high EQ. And EQ is responsible for 58% of your job performance. Also, a person having a high EQ was earning $29,000 more as compared to an equivalent low EQ counterpart. So what am I trying to tell? What I'm trying to tell is that EQ can help us in improving and building our personal as well as professional relationships. So this is what I'm trying to tell. There are so many tools available online to test.